Math 1, Unit 8, Quadratic Functions. Math is all about becoming a creative thinker, not a calculator. As you start this unit, use this quote to help you reflect on how you are capable of thinking and solving mathematical problems. The big ideas for this unit include creating multiple representations of quadratic functions, finding key features of quadratic functions, and comparing quadratic functions to both linear and exponential functions. In this unit, you will learn how to write quadratic equations in factored form to help you find the side lengths of area models and x-intercepts of quadratic functions. You will model projectile motion with an equation to solve problems related to the height and time of the object in motion, and you will also compare the rates of change and end behavior of quadratic functions to those of linear and exponential functions. In the first three lessons, you will develop strategies for factoring quadratic expressions. You will build off of your work with area models from the previous unit. The word factoring is a verb used to describe the process of creating an expression that shows how the multiplication of factors represents a product. In the previous unit, you multiplied linear expressions. In these lessons, you will undo that multiplication. In the fourth lesson, you will solve quadratic equations and learn how writing a quadratic equation in factored form can make it easier to solve. You'll be reminded of the zero product property, which reminds us that if you are multiplying factors and the answer is zero, then one of those factors you multiplied has to be zero. In the example shown, there are three factors being multiplied: 2, x plus 2, and x plus 4. X equaling negative 2 can make one of these factors equal 0, and x equaling negative 4 can make another one of these factors equal 0. That means that the answer to this problem is x equals negative 2 and x equals negative 4. In the next four lessons, you will model real-world context with quadratic functions. Lessons 5 and 6 provide examples of projectile motion problems, where quadratic functions model the relationship between time and the height of a projectile. Lessons 7 and 8 provide contextual quadratic problems involving profit as a function of the price of an item. In all four lessons, you will use different representations of the function to solve problems. You'll interpret parts of the equations, and you'll identify and interpret key features of the function. In Lesson 9, you'll compare quadratic functions to linear and exponential functions. You'll look at their rates of change and end behavior. Here is a list of key vocabulary terms for this unit. Some of these vocabulary terms should already be familiar to you from previous courses. Here are some key skills needed to be successful with the content in this unit. You should be able to multiply polynomials. Understand that if the product is zero, at least one of the factors is zero. Understand the definition of a function, and represent a function with a table and a graph. In addition to your teacher and school-based resources, there are several additional resources available. The Ready, Set, Go homework help videos are housed in the Canvas site for your class. You can access these in Canvas using your student login. If you do not know how to log into Canvas, ask your teacher. The K-12 Math Resource website, which can be found on your school's website, includes additional support items such as unit and lesson overviews, videos overviewing the tasks, essential vocabulary, the North Carolina standards for each unit, learning targets for each lesson, and extra practice problems.